How is it going, ladies and gentlemen? This is the Wolf Around, and it's great to see you here. In this video, I'll show you how to compile OpenCV from its source code while enabling Python bindings. With this method, you can customize OpenCV during compilation by enabling or disabling features like GPU hardware acceleration. On top of that, the compiled OpenCV binaries will work seamlessly in both Python and C++ programs. Subscribe to the channel, join the pack, you are always welcome here. Without further ado, let's get started. Compiling a library from its source code offers great flexibility for your projects. You can enable or disable features as needed. Install any version you prefer. Choose the installation location. Remove it easily whenever you want. I've written a base script to automate this process and make it easier to explain. The script will check for required dependencies. It will verify each dependency and install any missing ones. Set the version info. The latest OpenCV release version is 4.10.0, which I'll use in this video. You can modify this line in the script to use your preferred version. Set the source code and installation directories for OpenCV. You can change the installation directory, for example, to a folder under your home directory. However, if you enable Python bindings during the compilation, you must keep these binaries safe. If they are accidentally deleted later, OpenCV functionalities in your Python code will stop working. To avoid this, I recommend installing OpenCV under USR local. This keeps it secure and makes it easier to link against in CMake configurations for C++ projects. Check if OpenCV and OpenCV contrib source code are already downloaded. OpenCV contrib includes additional modules that provide extra functionality. It's essential to have both OpenCV and OpenCV contrib. Ask if you want to enable Python 3 integration. This step determines whether you want to use your compiled OpenCV binaries in Python 3. If yes, enter Y, and the script will ask for Python 3 version in the format major.minor, for example, 3.10. This is necessary because you might have multiple Python 3 versions installed. In my previous video, I showed how to compile Python 3 from its source code. Python is an interpreted programming language, and its interpreter is written in C. This interpreter executes your Python code. You can easily compile a custom Python 3 version by watching my earlier video. Check the link in the description. If you don't have any extra Python 3 versions installed, you can leave this prompt empty, and the script will use the default Python 3 on your system. Check if the NumPy library is installed. NumPy is required for OpenCV Python 3 bindings. The script includes the Python 3 NumPy package in the dependency list, but we'll still verify its presence. This ensures compatibility, especially if you are using a custom Python 3 where NumPy might not be installed. Handle scenarios without Python 3 integration. If you don't enable Python 3 integration, the script will disable OpenCV Python 3 compilation flag and explicitly ask whether you want to compile OpenCV in release or debug mode. Clear the CMake cache. Before configuring CMake, the script clears its cache. This prevents conflicts if you are integrate OpenCV binaries into multiple Python 3 versions. This ensures you don't need to recompile the entire library unnecessarily. Configure the CMake arguments. The script sets up arguments, including Python 3 paths and options to enable or disable features. I enabled necessary options and disabled unnecessary ones, like examples and tests. Three important options to note are with OpenCL, with CUDA, and with cuDNN. To enable these, you must have them installed on your system beforehand. For example, to enable with cuDNN, you need to install CUDA first, followed by cuDNN. Similarly, to enable OpenCL, you need to have OpenCL installed. I've created separate videos showing how to install OpenCL, CUDA, and cuDNN. Check the links in the description. Enabling these options provides GPU hardware acceleration for faster OpenCV operations. You can disable these options during compilation, but you won't be able to enable them later. It's better to enable them now, as you can decide whether to use them at runtime. Optimize the compilation process. The script detects your computer's maximum thread count and uses two fewer threads for compilation. Starts the compilation and installation. Finally, the script compiles OpenCV and installs it. Let's start the compilation. Open a terminal and make the script executable using the following command. Important warning. Since we enabled with OpenCL, with CUDA, and with cuDNN, the compilation process will take a long time. At some points, it might seem like it's stuck. Be patient and avoid canceling the compilation. Keep this in mind before starting. Once the dependencies are installed and the OpenCV source code is cloned, the script will prompt you to specify which Python version you want to use for OpenCV Python 3 integration. I'll first use the version of my custom Python 3 installation, which is 3.13. Later in this video, I'll also demonstrate using the default Python 3 pre-installed on my Linux system. The script will then configure CMake. After the configuration, it will prompt you to press any key to proceed with the compilation and installation. As I mentioned earlier, the compilation process will take a long time. I've speeded up during the video editing for your convenience. The compilation and installation are complete. Now, let's test it by running the Python 3 version I selected. I'll type Python 3.13 to launch the interpreter for my custom Python 3. Next, I'll import the CV2 module and print its version info. Since I successfully imported CV2 and printed the version, the OpenCV Python 3 integration is confirmed to be successful. However, I won't be able to import CV2 in the default Python 3 on my system. To integrate OpenCV with another Python 3 version, I'll rerun the script. The script indicates that to use the default Python 3, simply press Enter without entering a specific version. This time, the script won't recompile. It will only integrate it with the given Python 3 version. This process still takes some time, but it's much quicker than a full compilation. Once the integration is complete, I'll run the default Python 3 version. This time, I successfully imported CV2 and printed its version info, confirming that the integration is successful. By the way, you can find the compilation script in the video description. I'm a software engineer, specializing in computer graphics, game development, GPU hardware acceleration, AI inference, and cross-platform C++ development. I look forward to sharing more insights with you. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment. I'll see you in the next one.